People are making apocalypse jokes like there's no tomorrow. Too soon?
No, it's topical.
Today on Screen Rant, we're journeying into the post-apocalyptic world of The Last of Us.
And the government are all Nazis.
The government are all Nazis!
Well, yeah, now, but not then.
With HBO's filming of season 2 underway, we thought we'd take a look back over Pedro Pascal's portrayal of one of the most cherished characters in video game history, Joel Miller. Made iconic by Troy Baker through performance capture, there was great pressure for the HBO team to bring Miller to life without trying to mimic what's come before. Let's see how Pedro Pascal did it.
It's nice, but I think it's stuck. It's not...
What? No.
At the beginning of the game, Joel Miller turns 32. When we see him 20 years later, he is looking good. And I mean good for a man in his early 50s, having suffered some of the most traumatic experiences ever. Of course, gameplay mechanics means we also have to suspend our disbelief in certain physical ways. But until we did the math, we thought Joel Miller was in his early 40s. HBO ages Joel by 5 years. Although younger than older Joe in real life, Pedro Pascal can pass for both a hardworking 36-year-old and a 56-year-old who was in seemingly good shape before the apocalypse. His physical limitations are realistic. Limited crouching, the aged groans of someone whose knees have all but left them, and the exhaustion of dragging himself up 33 flights of stairs, all things many of us can relate to, sadly. Anyone who's paid attention in the games knows Joel's rage and detachment comes from fear of losing everything again. His irritation at Ellie's presence and general snarling guard dog demeanor at the beginning of the game makes him notorious as the Boston smuggler, and Tess uses this for her personal business interests. HBO's vision gives us a glimpse of this moodiness. The irritation towards others and Joel's short answers still prevails. But Pascal brings a human reality to his portrayal that shows cracks in the facade before he even meets Ellie. By episode 6, Joel's confession to Tommy just confirms what we've already seen. It's a big deviation from the original game scene, but I believe that although Troy Baker's Joel never said it, he is certainly thinking it loudly. Diehard fans of games know that there are only 2 times in the entire franchise where Joel drops the F-bomb. This was a character choice made by Troy Baker, based around Joel's parenting of Sarah. Its use in the game is due to scenes being shot early on in the process, before the idea was established. Though Pascal's Joel isn't liberal with the word, he definitely says it more than once. And for those who know the character, it's a big difference. Video game adaptations can be rough. However, having Neil Druckmann co-produce with Craig Mazin means that the changes worked. And Pedro Pascal provided us with a Joel that is just as beloved as his PlayStation counterpart. Thanks for watching Screen Rant. Stay tuned for more movie news.